year at Christmas, one of my favorite things that I look forward to is a chocolate orange in my stocking. I love to unwrap the crinkly paper and separate the segments. I carefully examine each decorated slice and breathe in the chocolate aroma. Then, finally, I savor the sweet, orangey chocolatey goodness. But chocolate has been around for a lot longer than they've been making it into chocolate oranges. Chocolate was first enjoyed by the Mayan people thousands of years ago. Good evening, my name is Joel Denham, and I'm an 11-year-old member of the Calling Out 4-H Club. This afternoon, I would like to tell you about the Mayans and their love of chocolate. The first evidence of chocolate was found in a Mayan clay pot dated back to 600 years ago. Mayans loved chocolate and made it as a frothy drink, a bit like a zesty version of hot cocoa. Mayan cacao harvesters would hike up a steep mountain slope and collect the cacao pods, which they would then slice open to remove 30 to 50 cacao seeds within. These beans were put under piles of leaves with yeast to ferment. When they were done fermenting, they were left to dry in the heat of the sun for a week. Then they were roasted in the same process used to turn coffee beans into coffee. The importance of cacao to the Mayans is truly impressive. The sweet-toothed Mayans revered chocolate, calling it the food of the gods. Among many gods in their culture, both a god and goddess of chocolate. Many Mayan infants were actually baptized in a mixture of water, chocolate, and flowers. The Mayans even thought that cacao had magical properties. They believed chocolate was life-giving and medicinal, so the drink made from it was good for the soul and brought long life. In addition to consuming this delicious delicacy, they also used cacao as a form of money, and it held its value even into the afterlife, as many Mayans were buried with pots of chocolate. In fact, the majority of pottery found in Mayan archaeological sites have been vessels for holding chocolate. I may love to eat chocolate at Christmas, or Valentine's Day, or Halloween, or Easter, or my birthday, but worshiping it and taking it to the grave is a little